Hello, my name is Roberto Fairhurst. I am originally from Argentina, but currently I am doing my master slash PhD in the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. I came here as part of a class organized by UFI with KTH. I am currently doing my master, as I said. Our research consists of fuel cycle. We are working on a fuel cycle simulator. I am also interested in generation 4 reactors, more in particular molten salt reactors. So basically my life consists of research, taking classes, but also during my free time I enjoy a lot doing sports and hanging out with friends. So I think for other people in our universities and especially at UFI, I think this is a great opportunity to meet people from all around the world, from Europe, from Asia, and also from America. Yes, so I think that's one of the most important things in the course, are the relationships that we produce here, all the people that we met here. I think that is very positive. And I think the course is really good. Even though I thought geology wasn't interesting, I think this is a really important part of the field cycle, and especially the people that we met here.
Hi, my name is Tim Narman. I'm from the University of Illinois from Champaign-Urbana. I've lived in Illinois my entire life. I'm starting my final year of my undergraduate program in nuclear engineering. I think this program is really special because, especially in the U.S., we don't quite yet have a final solution for nuclear waste. And this was a good overview of all the work that goes into choosing a geological repository, as well as a lot of the work and research that goes into actually creating these repositories, whether it's from initial siting of geological resources or ending it with the canister sealing and actually sealing away the nuclear fuel for thousands of years. It's something that we really need in America, as well as the fact that this is probably one of the better foreign exchange programs that we have, considering it's not just going off to another country, but rather going off to another country, meeting with a bunch of people from around the world who are all studying similar things as ourselves, and learning a little global perspective on things that we're all interested in.
I'm Kip Kleimenhagen. I'm a junior at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, also in the Nuclear Engineering Department. My main interests are the Generation 4 reactors, namely the sodium fast reactor. Typically, I'm more of a hands-on guy, so this course really provided me with a unique opportunity to see some of the things we talk about in lecture in real life. We just got back from the ESPA Hard Rock Laboratory, and it was really neat to see something like that in real life. You know, you see diagrams for Yucca Mountain, which is drilled into volcanic tuff instead of bedrock, but kind of an interesting feeling being half a kilometer underground, nothing but rock above you. The Swedish terrain here is quite different from our own, but still we can draw many analogs back to the connection, back to the studies we have to do in the U.S. for siting and construction of the repository. I've had a lot of fun here. I met a lot of new friends, met people from all over the world. My mom's from China, and there's several students from the university she went to attending this course right now. It's been interesting talking with them, seeing what's changed over there the last 40 years. Other than that, I would highly recommend this course. I feel like it's broadened my perspective, and it's a time I won't forget.
Hello, I'm Christian Chang. I'll be a junior in nuclear engineering, or nuclear plasma radiological engineering at University of Illinois. I'm also part of the Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps at the University of Illinois, so that means I will not exactly be going into the nuclear engineering industry once I graduate, but more into the Navy as a commissioned officer. So basically my interests are anything nuclear engineering related, especially when it pertains to naval interests. But I'm also particularly interested in mainly future energy production involving fission and fusion reactors, or a combination of both, to solve energy problems that may arise in the near or very distant future. Basically, from this course, it's a lot of fun. You get to travel outside the U.S., which I don't think a lot of people from the U.S. get to do. And I think that offers a very unique perspective in terms of socially, culturally, and politically, when you are able to be exposed to different cultures and different types of people, as well as when they're from the same area of study that you're trying to study. And I also think it gives you a better respect for what geologists do in regards to how it ties into all types of engineering, not just nuclear engineering. Thank you.
So we found a big set of fractures here that are the longest ones that we have in our region, and we call it the great Professor William Roy.
Okay, so he will be really fractured with that. Yes, yes. I sent him this video clip.
One more time or no?
No.
No more time.
Stop. Hello, my name is Anish Talam. I'm from the University of Illinois studying nuclear engineering. I currently finished my second year of undergraduate, and I will be attending my third year in the University of Illinois as well. Number one, I actually very, very much do love the course. It gives me a international study abroad opportunity. It gives me an opportunity to meet with other fellow people. Through this course, I've met many, many new friends. I've met many new friends through different countries. Not only that, I've made many new experiences. I've known different stuff about the radioactive waste management in Sweden and what could be done possibly in America in the future to store radioactive waste. And this experience was practically short and sweet, and I would recommend everyone to go through it. And especially for the people of University of Illinois, we will be given 4 credits for just 10-day course, which you will definitely learn much more about. And that's something that I really do enjoy, and plus you get to have like an international study abroad experience, which all the satisfactions do meet for a good study abroad experience. Oskarshamn, I live in a cabin with three other people, and I do not know these people currently, but as of now they are currently, I would say, my best friends. So I love the new cooking experience with them, waking up very late, just barely making the bus in time, and making it to class just in time. It's just a new thing that everybody should experience, I believe.
Good.